The first thing I will do is to make some color adjustments for this text, so I double click here to enter the layer style options. You can also do this by right clicking on the text layer and choosing blending options. To create a realistic effect, you always need to analyze where the main light is coming from. So in this case, if I look at these leaves, looks like the light is coming from the top left, and this means that the leaves will cast some shadows on the bottom right. Also, the text will look much better if I apply a gradient to it, a color gradient. So let's see, I will give you the exact codes for the colors that I use, but first, let's check this box right here, which says gradient overlay. Make sure the blend mode is set to normal, opacity to 100, negative 90 for the angle of the gradient, and make it linear. The codes for the colors are, for the left side, F4E99C, and for the right side, CDB933. Hit OK, and now let's check this box for bevel and emboss. Choose inner bevel. This slider controls the depth, and I found that for me, 105 is the perfect value. You can choose different numbers if you want, especially if you're using another image. You need to adjust these accordingly depending on many variables. But for this tutorial, you can use my values. It's a lot simpler. So let's move on. 24 pixels for the size and 7 pixels for the soften value. Okay, that's it. Let's hit OK. And for now, we are finished with the text. The next step is a bit time consuming, but you need to do it if you want the final result. You have no choice. I need to bring some of the leaves on top of my text, but first I need to see which of the leaves. So I will lower the opacity of the text layer to 40% to make it easier for me. And I have to decide which of the leaves I want to be in front of the text, on top of the text. For example, this one right here, I want it to be on top. This one, I can choose this one too, and so on, for each of the letters. I need to make some precise selections. I will use the pen tool and create some shapes that I will convert in selections later. It sounds complicated, but it's not. Just look at what I'm doing. So I just press P on the keyboard to enable the pen tool. From this drop down, I choose shape. Also, disable the fill. Choose a red color for the stroke and make it 2 pixels thick. I hold down the Z to zoom in here, and I will create a precise shape only where the leaves are covering the letter. On the outside of the letter, I just create a rough selection, something like this. Let's do this one as well. Meanwhile, you can see that the shape layers are adding up in the layers panel on the right. I will show you what to do about that after I created all the shapes here. So let's speed up the video here and listen to some music from Epidemic Sound. It's a platform with great tracks. You can get a free trial if you access my affiliation link in my description. It's one of the ways you can support this channel so that I can create free tutorials on YouTube. Okay, the shapes are ready. I will select the first one in the list, hold down Shift, select the last one, right click and choose Merge Layers. All the shapes are on a single layer now, and this is great because I can keep the layer area much cleaner. I will rename this to shapes. Now I need to convert these shapes into selections. I hit P to enable the pen tool. Just go with the mouse inside of any shape layer, right click, and choose Make Selection. I will go with a feather of 2 pixels, but this depends on the size of your image, so you need to adjust this accordingly, depending on how smooth you want the selection to be. I have an active selection now from the shapes, so I will select the background layer and press Ctrl J to create a copy of those areas only. A new layer was created above the background image, containing only the leaves that will stay on the top of my text. You can see them better if I just hide the shapes layer and the background image. For now, I don't need the shapes, so I can just grab this layer and put it below the background image and keep it hidden. And also, I will rename this layer to leaves. Now I need to drag the text layer between the main image and the leaves, because this should be the correct order. Here comes that part that will make a huge difference in terms of realism. I will show you how to add shadows under the leaves. First, I will bring back the opacity of the text layer to 100. I will create the shadows using the blending options, but here is what happens. If I create a shadow, it will be visible on the background as well, and I need to avoid this. To solve this issue, I will hold down Ctrl, click on the text to create a selection, select the layer with the leaves, and create a new layer mask. Now, as you can see, the shadows are limited to the text area only. Before tweaking the shadows, there are two more problems that I need to solve. Now the shadows are limited to the text, but still, I have a shadow on the background image. This could be solved by entering the blending options once again and checking this box called Layer Mask Hides Effects. And now I really have shadows under the leaves only. The second issue is this white thin line around the letters. I'm not sure if you can see this on YouTube, but if I zoom in here, they disappear. But still, it's a bit frustrating, but I can solve this easily. I just unlink the layer mask to be independent. Select the layer mask, then go to Edit, Transform, Scale, and then up here, add the percentage, I will put 100.1. Then I go back and link back the layer with the mask. As you can see, that line disappeared. Okay, it's time to work on the shadows now, and I will create two of them, a harder one and a softer one. Watch this. For the hard drop shadow, I use these options after some trials, so you may need to spend time if you use a different image. 120 degrees, 15 for the opacity, distance 20, spread 8, and size 21. Now, did you know that you can add another drop shadow effect on top of this one? Yes, you can. And this will be the soft shadow. Just click on this plus icon and you have the second shadow. For this one, here are my settings. Like I said, this is a softer shadow with a bigger size at a greater distance. 35 for the opacity, 85 for distance, 0 for spread, and 75 for size. Just hit OK and let's look at the text again. This is how you can transform a boring text into something special, something different that instantly catches your eyes. If you enjoyed this video, give me a like, make sure you subscribe and click the bell for other future tutorials and product reviews related to photography and videography. I'm Chris, thanks a lot for watching and see you next time here on iStalker.